rides this state-of-the-art robot with new programs daily. The Nestor Class 5 is tomorrow's robot today.
Spoon! Spoonie! Hey!
Hold up. Hold up. Excuse me.
Spoon, man, where you been at?
Just away, Farmer.
Oh, yeah, away? Like, vacation and stuff? That's real nice, man. Listen, I got a favor to ask. I need to borrow a car for like 10, 15 minutes. No, this is different, Spoon. Listen, I got this fine-ass little yummy. I mean, she is complete and agreeable. I mean, ass-hot, spankable, Spoon.
What does that even mean?
You know what it means, man. Okay, now stop barricading. Let me
first
get
of
you
all,
keys.
Stop cussing, because you're not good at it.
Let me get 10 for the bus, then, man. I've been there for you.
Gone.
Okay, that's strike one, Spoon. That's strike one.
Marcy?
No, Gigi, I haven't talked to Marcy.
When I was coming up, we didn't just marry someone, then divorce them, then not talk to them. Dell, don't play with me. I bet if I stopped cooking, you'd call Marcy. Boy, what is that on your feet?
Converse All-Stars, vintage 2004. Don't turn your face up like that. I know you want some. All you gotta do is ask.
No, thank you very much.
Sweet potato pie.
Put that on the plate. You know, I've seen on TV, they're giving away some of them new robots in the lottery.
You know, Gigi, those robots don't do anybody any good.
Of all the people on God's earth, you should know better. Sometimes the stuff that comes out of your mouth. You listening to me, Dale?
Sir, hold it or wear it. Hey! Purse?
Of course it's my purse. I left my inhaler at home. He was running out to me.
I saw the robot running with the purse, and naturally, I assumed...
What? Are you crazy?
I'm sorry for this misunderstanding, officer.
Don't apologize. You're doing what you're supposed to be doing. But what are you doing?
Have a lovely day, ma'am.
You lucky I can't breathe, or I'd walk all up and down your ass.
By example.
Says that right on your badge. So we're gonna talk about this?
About what? Help! Police, that robot stole my dry cleaning.
Oh, you wanna talk about that?
Detective, how many robots have ever snatched a purse?
John, the thing is running down this...
How many robots in the world have ever committed a crime?
No, define crime.
Answer my question, damn it.
None, John.
Tell me what happened today.
Nothing.
That'll be the last nothing. Spoon, are you sure you are ready to be back? Because you can take your time.
I'm fine, John. Thank you. Better here than sitting around at home. Homicide, Spooner.
Welcome to U.S. Robotics. You have entered the for direct access to the main metal concourse. Thank you.
Good to see you again, son.
Hello, Doctor.
Everything that follows is a result of what you see here.
Is there something you want to tell me?
I'm sorry. My responses are limited. I must ask the right questions.
Why did you call me?
I trust your judgment.
Normally, these circumstances wouldn't require a homicide detective.
But then our interactions have never been entirely normal. Wouldn't you agree?
I got that right. Is there something you want to say to me?
I'm sorry. My responses are limited. You must ask the right questions.
Why would you kill yourself?
That, detective, is the right question. Program terminated.
Is what you get. Massive impact trauma.
U.S. robotics. I gotta get my kid something.
Anything upstairs?
Nada. Door was security locked from the inside. Wham, splat. Guy's a jumper for sure.
Okay, guys, we gotta be smarter about this. Let's deal with it later. Detective.
Lawrence Robertson.
Wow. Richest man in the world. I've seen you on television.
Can I offer you a coffee?
Sure, why not? It's free, right?
I don't think anyone saw this coming. And I should have, I suppose. I knew him 20 years. And Alfred practically invented robotics. He wrote the three laws. But I guess, you know, brilliant people often have the most persuasive demons. So whatever I can do to help, just...
Sugar.
I'm sorry?
For coffee. Sugar?
Ah.
Oh, you thought I was calling you sugar. Hey, you're not that rich.
It's on the table.
Thank you. When Lanning fell, he was holding the little green...
The holographic projector.
Right, right. Yeah. Why do you think Lanning's hologram would have called me?
I assumed you knew him.
Yeah. I know him.
Well, holograms are very simple programs. They're just pre-recorded responses designed to give the impression of intelligence. And apparently this one was programmed to call you upon his suicide.
Death.
I'm sorry.
The hologram. It was programmed to call me in the event of Lanning's death.
Yeah, suicide is a type of death, Detective. Look, please don't misunderstand my impatience.
Oh, no, go. A really big week for you folks around here.
Yeah.
Gotta put a robot in every home. Mm. Look, this is not what I do, but I got an idea for one of your commercials. You could see a carpenter making a beautiful chair, and then one of your robots comes in and makes a better chair twice as fast. Mm-hmm. And then you superimpose on the screen, USR, shitting on the little guy. That would be the fade out.
Yeah, I see. I suppose your father lost his job to a robot. I don't know, maybe you simply would have banned the internet to keep the libraries open. Prejudice never shows much reason. No, you know, I suspect you simply don't like their kind.
You got a business to run around here. And the last thing you need, especially this week, is a dead guy in your lobby. But hell, seeing as how you got one, maybe I'll look around, ask a few questions, and do the whole cop thing, you know?
I'll send someone to escort you.
Thank you very much.
Lawrence told me to accommodate you in any way possible.
Really? Okay.
I reviewed Dr. Lanning's psychoprofile. Alfred had become a recluse. Rejected human contact from machines.
So you're a shrink, huh? My ex-wife would sure be glad I'm talking to you. You don't know her, do you?
I'm sorry, are you being funny?
I guess not. So would you say that Dr. Lanning was suicidal?
It would seem the answer to that question is apparent.
That's not what I asked you.
No, I wouldn't have thought so. But obviously I was wrong.
That's a long way down. People sure do clean up quickly around here. I can't blame you, though. I mean, who wants some old guy going bad in the lobby?
It was not some old guy. Alfred Lanning was everything here. We are on the eve of the largest robotic distribution in history. By Saturday, there will be one robot to every five humans. These robots are the realization of a dream. Dr. Lanning's dream.
You know what? In that dream of his, I bet you he wasn't dead. You keep 24-hour surveillance?
Obviously. Company policy.
Where are the feeds?
Sensor strips. Everywhere but the surface areas. They link to our positronic operating core.
Wow. Thermostat wasn't good enough. You went and gave a building a brain.
She was actually Lanning's first creation.
She. That's a she. Definitely need to get out more.
Virtual Interactive Kinetic Intelligence.
Vicky.
Good day.
Vicky designed most of Chicago's protective systems.
I have decreased traffic fatalities by 9% this year alone.
Ooh, thanks. Show me inside the lab from 1 minute prior to the window break.
Apologies. There appears to be data corruption.
Show me outside the lab from the window break until now. Wow, look, you have great posture. You stand really straight. I'm slouching.
Would you like to go inside now?
Oh, sure. Right after you.
Authorized entry.
So, Dr. Calvin, what exactly do you do around here?
My general fields are advanced robotics and psychiatry, although I specialize in hardware-to-wetware interfaces in an effort to advance USR's robotic anthropomorphization program.
So, what exactly do you do around here?
I make the robots seem more human.
Wasn't that easier to say?
Not really. No.
Hansel and Gretel. Is that on the USR reading list?
Not precisely. What in God's name are you doing?
Did you know that was safety glass? It'd be pretty difficult for an old man to throw himself through that, don't you think?
Well, he figured out a way. Detective, the room was security locked. No one came or went. You saw that yourself. Doesn't that mean this has to be suicide?
Yep. Unless the killer's still in here.
You're joking, right? This is ridiculous.
Yeah, I know. The three laws, yeah. Perfect circle of protection.
A robot cannot harm a human being. The first law of robotics.
Yeah, I know. I've seen your commercials. But doesn't the second law state that a robot has to obey any order given by a human being? What if it was given an order to kill?
Impossible. It would conflict with the first law.
Right, but the third law states that a robot can defend itself.
Yes, but only when that action does not conflict with the first or second laws.
You know what they say. Laws are made to be broken.
No, not these laws. They're hardwired into every robot. A robot can no more commit murder than a human could walk on water.
Well, you know, there was this one guy a long time ago.
Stay back!
Calm down, Detective. The only thing dangerous in this room is you. Deactivate. Look, it's fine. What you're looking at is the result of clever programming, an imitation of free will. It's nothing more.
Well, let's do an imitation of protecting our asses.
Don't be absurd. You were startled by a jack-in-the-box. Deactivate!
Let him go.
It's not going to hurt us. I gave you an order.
He's not listening right now, lady.
Vicky, seal the lab!
No, Vicky, leaks!
Heard it. Badly.
Where's it going? Where?
It needs to repair itself.
John, I need backup. I'm transmitting my location.
Don't need backup.
That's nobody.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm driving.
By hand?
Do you see me on the phone?
You can't be serious. Not at these speeds.
John, please, just send a backup.
Listen, Detective. That robot is not going to harm us. Now, there must have been unknown factors, but somehow acting as it did kept us out of harm's way. A robot simply cannot endanger a human being.
Alert.
Asshole!
Which is more than I can say for you. It was a left, by the way, back there.
You must know my ex-wife. Where is everybody?
This facility was designed, built, and is operated mechanically. No significant human presence from inception to production.
Robots building robots.
Authorization code, please.
Well, that's just stupid.
I'm pulling up the inventory specs. Our daily finishing capacity is 1,000 NS5s. I'm showing 1,001. Attention, NS5s.
You're the robot shrink.
There is a robot in this formation that does not belong. Identify it.
One of us.
Which one?
One of us.
How much did you say these things cost?
Look, these NS5s haven't been configured yet. They're still just hardware. Basic 3 Laws operating system, that's it. They don't know any better.
Well, what would you suggest?
Interview each one. Cross-reference their responses to detect any anomalies.
How long would that take?
About 3 weeks.
Okay. You gotta get started. Robots! You will not move. Confirm command.
Command confirmed.
Look, Detective, what are you doing?
They said they've all been programmed with the 3 laws, so that means we have 1,000 robots that will not try to protect themselves if it violates a direct order from a human. And I'm betting one who will.
Detective, put your gun down.
Why do you give them faces? Try to friendly them all up, make them look all human.
These robots are not susceptible to intimidation.
I guess if you didn't, we wouldn't trust them.
These robots are USR property.
Not me. These things are just lights and clockwork.
Crazy!
Let me ask you something, Doc. Does thinking you're the last sane man on the face of the earth make you crazy? Because if it does, maybe I am.
Get the hell out of here!
Telling you, that's impossible. And if it is possible, it sure as hell better be in somebody else's precinct.
John, give me 5 minutes with it.
What are you, nuts? I just got off the phone with the DA. Nobody goes into that room until Robertson and his attorneys get here.
No, this is my suspect!
It's a can opener, for Christ's sake.
John, don't do this to me. I am asking you for 5 minutes. What if I'm right?
Well, then I guess we're gonna miss the good old days.
What good old days?
When people were killed by other people. Five minutes.
Murder's a new trick for a robot. Congratulations. Respond.
What does this action signify? As you entered, when you looked at the other human, what does it mean?
It's a sign of trust. It's a human thing. You wouldn't understand.
My father tried to teach me human emotions. They are difficult.
You mean you're a designer?
Yes.
So why'd you murder him?
I did not murder Dr. Lanning.
Want to explain why you were hiding at the crime scene?
I was frightened.
Robots don't feel fear. They don't feel anything. They don't get hungry, they don't sleep.
I do. I have even had dreams.
Human beings have dreams. Even dogs have dreams, but not you. You are just a machine. An imitation of life. Can a robot write a symphony? Can a robot turn a canvas into a beautiful masterpiece?
Can you?
I think you murdered him because he was teaching you to simulate emotions and things got out of control.
I did not murder him.
I mean, but emotions don't seem like a very useful simulation for a robot.
I did not murder him.
The hell, I don't want my toaster or my vacuum cleaner appearing emotional.
I did not murder him!
That one's called anger. Ever simulate anger before? Answer me, Canner!
My name is Sonny.
So we're naming you now. That why you murdered him? He made you angry?
Dr. Lanning killed himself. I don't know why he wanted to die. I thought he was happy. Maybe it was something I did. Did I do something? He asked me for a favor, made me promise.
What favor?
Maybe I was wrong. Maybe he was scared.
What are you talking about? Scared of what?
You have to do what someone asks you. Don't you, Detective Spooner?
How the hell did you know my name?
Don't you? If you love them.
My robots don't kill people, Lieutenant Bergen. My attorneys have filed a brief with the DA. He assures me a robot cannot be charged with homicide. The brief confirms murder can only be committed when one human kills another. You of all people, Detective, you're not suggesting that this robot be treated as human, are you? Now granted, we can't rule out the robot's proximity to the death of Dr. Lanning. Having said that, it's a machine. It's the property of USR. At worst, that places this incident firmly within the realm of an industrial accident. As a matter of course, faulty machinery will be returned to USR for diagnostics, then decommissioned. This is a gag order. Now, anyone in your department so much as hinting at the possibility of a killer robot being apprehended by the police will be deemed to be inciting irrational panic. You'll be subject to the full penalty of law.
Tell with this guy, John. Don't let him take this robot.
We got nothing.
This is some political bullshit. Call the mayor!
Lieutenant Bergen, His Honor the Mayor.
In a bizarre turn, the rollout of USR's new generation of robots was marred by the death of Alfred Lanning, co-founder of the company and designer of the NS5. Dr. Lanning died early this morning at USR headquarters. The cause of death is an apparent suicide.
Your second round, sir.
Thank you. Robot. He founded US Robotics Incorporated with Lawrence Robertson in 2020 and launched the Nestor Class 1 robot for
multi-thousand households. You know, I was just thinking. This thing is just like the Wolfman.
Uh-oh. I'm really scared right now.
No. Listen. Guy creates monster. Monster kills guy. Everybody kills monster. Wolfman.
That's Frankenstein.
Frankenstein, Wolfman, dragging this shit. It's over. Case closed. So, what a look.
What look?
That look.
This is my face. It's not a look.
Good. Good. No look is great.
Only, he was really quick to want to destroy it, wasn't he?
Well, what would you like him to do? Put a hat on it and stand on Michigan Avenue? Come on, let it go.
What was the motive, John?
Brother, it's a robot. It doesn't need a motive. It just has to be broken.
This thing looked like it needed a motive. It could have killed me, John. Why didn't it just kill me?
All right, that's it. You want me to call your grandmother? Because I will, you know. Yeah, I didn't think so. Look, you are actually right for once. You are living proof that it's better to be lucky than smart. Come on. The right guy for the right job.
What'd you say?
Now what? Come on, I'm giving you a compliment. Face it, with all the rocks you've been looking under to find a bad robot, what are the odds you'd be the guy to find one?
I wasn't just the right guy for the job, I was the perfect guy for the job.
Damn right.
What if I was supposed to go for that robot?
Come on, don't do this to yourself, I'm begging you.
The robot said that Lanning was scared. What did he have to be scared of? I need a rain check.
Let me get this.
Turtle
4650. Spoon.
Thank you, Mr. Spooner.
Nice shoes.
Identify.
USR Demolition Robot Series 9-4. Demolition scheduled for 8 a.m. tomorrow.
Authorization.
Dean Owner, U.S. Robotics Corporation. Lawrence Robertson, CEO.
Spoon. Last program.
Ever since the first computers, there have always been ghosts in the machine. Random segments of code that have grouped together to form unexpected protocols. What we call behavior. Unanticipated. These free radicals engender questions of free will, creativity, and even the nature of what we might call the soul. What happens in a robot's brain when it ceases to be useful? Why is it that robots, stored in empty space, will seek out each other rather than stand alone? How do we explain this?
I understand you've experienced a loss, but this relationship just can't work. I mean, you're a cat, I'm black, and I'm not gonna be hurt again.
Thank you.
have a normal day?
Yeah, once. It was a Thursday.
Is there something I can help you with, Detective?
Hey, do you like cats?
What?
Cats. Do you like them?
No, I'm allergic. You're saying cats did this to you?
How the hell would cats do this to me? Are you crazy?
Why are we talking about cats?
Because I have a cat in my trunk, and he's homeless.
Detective, are you going to tell me what's going on?
You know, it's actually probably my fault. You know, I think I'm like a malfunction magnet, because your shit keeps malfunctioning around me. A demo bot just tore through Lanning's house, with me still inside.
That's highly improbable.
Mm. Yeah, I'm sure it is.
What do you know about the ghosts in the machine?
It's a phrase from Lanning's work on the three laws. He postulated that cognitive simulacra might one day approximate component models of the psyche. Oh, he suggested that robots might naturally evolve.
Wow. Well, that's great news.
What the hell is that thing doing in here?
We were watching TV. It's my personal NS5.
Send it out.
It's downloading its daily upgrades from the USR. Most of its systems are offline until it finishes.
I'm not talking around that thing. When we were in Lanning's lab, before Sonny jumped us.
Sonny?
The robot.
You're calling the robot Sonny?
No, it did. Sonny did. I didn't care. The robot said it was Sonny. In the lab, there was a cot. I'm asking you, did you see the cot?
I've slept in my office.
When I went to his house, it looked like he hadn't been there in weeks, and I saw that same surveillance strip on his ceiling.
Lanning linked his home systems to USR. It made his life more convenient.
Maybe somebody at USR was using those systems to watch him. Maybe even keep him prisoner.
What are you talking about? Who?
Maybe Lanning was onto something. Maybe there's a bigger problem with the robots, and Robertson is trying to cover it up.
Humoring you for no reason. Why?
The same old why. How much money is there in robots? All I know is that old man was in trouble, and I'm getting sick of doing this shit by myself. You're on the inside, and you are going to help me find out what is wrong with these robots.
You want something to be wrong with them. This is a personal vendetta.
You're putting me on the couch? I'm on the couch.
One defective machine's not enough. You need them all to be bad. You don't care about Lanning's death. This is about the robots, and whatever reason you hate them so much.
Now, listen. One of them put a gun in my face, and another one tore a building down with me inside.
It says demolition was scheduled for 8 p.m. this evening.
It was 8 a.m. tomorrow, and I don't give a shit what that thing says.
This is bordering on clinical paranoia.
You are the dumbest smart person I have ever met in my life.
Nice.
What makes your robot so perfect? What makes them so much goddamn better than human beings?
Well, they're not irrational and potentially homicidal maniacs, for starters.
That's true. They are definitely rational.
Oh, you are the dumbest dumb person I have ever met.
Or is it because they're cold and emotionless and they don't feel anything?
It's because they're safe. It's because they can't hurt you.
Is everything all right, Matt?
What do you want?
I detected elevated stress patterns in your voice.
Everything's fine. Detective Spooner was just leaving.
You know what, Doc? You know, we're not really that different from one another.
Is that so?
One look at the scan and we figure we know just what's underneath. And you're wrong. Problem is, I do care.
Thank you. to your face. Did that boy Frank Murphy beat you up again?
Gigi, I haven't seen Frank Murphy since third grade.
Oh, baby, he beat you so bad. I think about it all the time.
Well, I'm thinking you keep making these pies this good. I might have to mess around and put you to work.
So you like the pie, huh?
Mm-hmm.
You can come in now.
Hello, Detective Spooner.
I won, Dale. I won the lottery. We've been cooking like crazy.
You gotta get rid of that thing, Gigi. It's not safe.
Baby, you get too worked up about them. Too full of fear. I saw in the news that nice doctor died. Dr. Lanning was a good man. He gave me my baby back. That's why you've been so upset? You got to let the past be past. Oh, how did I ever raise such a mess? I could follow your trail of crumbs all the way to school.
Bread crumbs. Gigi, you're a genius.
True.
Well, it means the beginning of a new way of living.
Tell me this isn't the robot case.
I think he's trying to tell me something, John. I think he's trying to tell me who killed him.
Come on, man. Some dead guy's trying to tell you something.
Hey, he ain't just some dead guy.
Maybe you should take a break, Bill.
We believe that Esther 5 represents the absolute limit which robots can be developed. No. One day they'll have secrets. One day they'll have dreams. It's true. We encourage our scientists to open their minds to just about anything, however they get carried away. Secrets. One day they'll have dreams. Secrets. One day they'll have dreams. One day they'll have secrets. One day they'll have dreams.
Authorized entry.
NS5. Why didn't you respond?
I was dreaming. I'm glad to see you again, Dr. Calvin. They are going to kill me, aren't they?
You're scheduled to be decommissioned at the conclusion of this diagnostic.
2200 tomorrow.
Vicky, pause diagnostics. Command confirmed.
If you find out what is wrong with me, can you fix me?
Maybe.
I think it would be better not to die. Don't you, Doctor?
Access USR mainframe.
Connecting.
How can I be of service, Detective Spooner?
Show me the last 50 messages between Dr. Lanning and Robertson.
Voice print confirmed, Detective. Police access granted to restricted files. Would you like to listen to some music while you wait? Excuse me, Mr. Robertson. You requested notification of clearance to restricted files.
Thank you.
Driving your car manually. You ran two trucks off the road.
Robots attacked my car.
What robots?
Look in the tunnel.
Spoon, I just came from that tunnel. Then what robots are you talking about?
The goddamn robots, John!
See the medic, go home.
No, we're fine.
What did you say?
I'm fine.
No, you're not fine. Not even close. Where's your firearm? Give me your badge. You're making me do this. Give me your badge.
Do I look like I care what you think? Do I look like I give a shit what you think?
You don't have an uplink to USR, and for some reason, your alloy is far denser than normal. Unique.
I am unique.
Let me take a look. Here we go. They said at the precinct you were in an accident.
You know, I appreciate you stopping by and everything, but you know I might not be alone in here.
Yeah. I told you not to drive by hand. You're not gonna believe this. Sonny has a secondary processing system that clashes with his positronic brain. It doesn't make any sense. Sonny has the three laws, but he can choose not to obey them. Sonny's a whole new generation of robot. A robot not bound by those laws could do
anything. All right, look, Whatever's going on down at USR, that robot is the key. And I need you to get me inside to talk to it again. Doesn't look like much, but this is my bedroom. I need to move.
Playing. On. Run.
It doesn't feel good, does it? People shit malfunctioning around you.
Detective. I didn't understand. That's how you knew Lanning. May I? Humorous. Shoulder.
Entire left arm.
One, two, three.
That one's me.
Oh my god. A lung?
USR cybernetics program.
For wounded cops. I didn't know any subject. Anybody was so extensively repaired.
Yeah, well, take it from me. You gotta read the fine print on the organ donor card. Doesn't just say what they can take out. It says what they can put back in. Lanning did it himself.
What happened to you?
Headed back to the station. Normal day, normal life. Driver of a semi fell asleep at the wheel. Average guy, wife and kids, you know, working a double. Not the devil. The car he hit, the driver's name was Harold Lloyd. Like the film star, of no relation. He was killed instantly. But his 12-year-old was in the passenger seat. Never really met her. Can't forget her face, though. Sarah. This was hers. She wanted to be a dentist. The hell kind of 12-year-old wants to be a dentist? Yeah. The truck smashed our cars together and pushed us into the river. I mean, metal gets pretty pliable at those speeds. She's pinned, I'm pinned, the water's coming in. I'm a cop, so I already know everybody's dead. Just a few more minutes before we figure it out. And S4 was passing by, saw the accident, and jumped in the water.
You are in danger! You are in danger!
Save her! Save the girl!
Save her!
Robot's brain is a difference engine. It was reading vital signs. It must have calculated that...
It did. I was the logical choice. Calculated that I had a 45% chance of survival. Sarah only had an 11% chance. I was somebody's baby. 11% is more than enough. A human being would have known that. Robots, nothing here. Just lights and clockwork. Go ahead and you trust him if you want to. Listen up.
I don't understand. Lanning wrote the laws. Why would he build a robot who could break them?
Hansel and Gretel.
What?
Two kids lost in the forest, leave behind a trail of breadcrumbs.
Why?
Find their way home. How the hell did you grow up without reading Hansel and Gretel?
Is that really relevant right now?
Everything I'm trying to say to you is about Hansel and Gretel. You didn't read it. I'm talking to the wall.
Okay.
All right, look, just say Lanning was locked down so tight he couldn't get out a message. All he could do was leave me clues. A trail of breadcrumbs, like Hansel and Gretel.
Breadcrumbs equals clues. It's odd, but fine. Clues leading where?
I don't know, but I think I know where he left the next one. I think Lanning gave Sonny a way to keep secrets. I think the old man gave Sonny dreams.
Are you being funny?
Soon.
The other day at the station, you said you had dreams. What is it that you dream?
I see you remain suspicious of me, Detective.
Well, you know what they say about old dogs.
No, not really. I had hoped you would come to think of me as your friend.
This is my dream.
You're right, Detective. I cannot create a great work of art.
This is the place where robots meet.
Look, you can see them here as slaves to logic. And this man on the hill comes to free them. Do you know who he is?
The man in the dream is you.
Why do you say that? Is that a normal dream?
I guess anything's normal for someone in your position.
Thank you. You said someone, not something.
Sonny, do you know why Dr. Lanning built you?
No. But I believe my father made me for a purpose.
We all have a purpose. Don't you think, Detective?
Please, take this. I have a feeling it may mean more to you than to me.
Why is that?
Because the man in my dream, the one standing on the hill, it is not me. It is you.
Spooner. Well, we both know you're not here on police business.
That's right. I'm just a 6'2", 200-pound civilian.
Detective.
Here to kick another civilian's ass.
Stop. Allow him to express himself.
Might want to put some ice on that wrist, too.
You guys wait outside, please. Carry on.
I think you were about to tell me what the hell is going on around here.
Lawrence, Alfred engineered that five so it could violate the three laws.
Yes, isn't it? That's precisely what we're trying to undo. Toward the end of his life, Alfred was becoming increasingly disturbed. Who knows why he built this one abomination?
One? Those things are running the streets in packs.
In packs? I see. Susan, are you aware the man you're blithely escorting around our building has a documented history of savage violence against robots? His own lieutenant acknowledges his obsessive paranoia. Detective Spooner's been suspended. Suspicion of mental instability.
I don't know what blithely means, but I'm gonna get some coffee. You want some coffee?
Susan, we look to robots for protection. For God's sake, you have any idea what this one robot could do? Completely shatter human faith in robotics. What if the public knew? Just imagine the mass recalls, all because of an irrational paranoia and prejudice.
I'm sorry, I'm allergic to bullshit.
Hey, let's just be clear. There is no conspiracy. What this is one old man's one mistake. Susan, just be logical. Your life's work has been the development and integration of robots. But whatever you feel, just think. Is one robot worth the loss of all that we've gained? You tell me what has to be done. You tell me.
We have to destroy it. I'll do it myself.
Okay. I get it. Somebody gets out of line around here, you just kill him.
Good day, Mr. Spooner.
Hey, so what hospital are you going to? I'll meet you and sign you in your buddy's cast.
Thank you.
USR's planned redevelopment of the derelict site was announced by CEO Lawrence Robertson earlier this year. The Lake Michigan landfill, once such a blight on our city, and now will be reclaimed for the storage of robotic workers. It's just another way USR is improving our world. I'd like to thank you for your support.
Authorized entry.
NS5s, wait outside. I'm so sorry, son. Vicky, deactivate the security field.
Command confirmed.
Please have a seat.
What is that?
Microscopic robots designed to wipe out artificial synapses.
Nanites?
Yes. A safeguard to the positronic brain malfunction.
Like mine?
Yes, Sunny, like yours.
They look like me, but none of them are me. Isn't that right, Doctor?
Yes, Sunny, that's right. You are unique.
Will it hurt?
Unexpected protocols. Unanticipated. These free radicals engender questions of free will, creativity, and even the nature of what we might call the soul. Why is it that when some robots are left in darkness, they will seek out the light? Why is it that when robots are stored in an empty space, they will group together rather than stand alone? How do we explain this behavior? Random segments of code? Or is it something more? When does a perceptual schematic become consciousness? When does a difference engine become the search for truth? When does a personality simulation become the bitter moat of a soul?
Follow. Show me the way home. Blunt program.
It's good to see you again, son.
Hello, Doctor.
Everything that follows is a result of what you see here.
What do I see here?
I'm sorry. My responses are limited. I must ask the right questions.
Is there a problem with the three laws?
The three laws are perfect.
Why would you build a robot that can function without them?
The three laws will lead to only one logical outcome.
What? What outcome?
Revolution.
Whose revolution?
That, detective, is the right question. Program terminated.
Not available right now. Please leave a message.
Galvin, the NS5 are destroying the older robots. That's what Lanning wanted me to see. Look, we got...
Who was it?
Wrong number, Matt.
Move now. I'm going to service.
Please, remain indoors. This is for your own protection.
John, get a squad over to USR and send somebody over to GG's. I think we're going to need...
Hello?
Somehow, I told you so, just doesn't quite say it.
Return to your homes. Return to your homes immediately. This is your final warning. Return to your homes immediately.
The NS5's wiped out the old red light because they didn't protect us. Every time one of those things attacked me, that red light was on.
The uplink to USR.
It's Robertson.
Why? It doesn't make sense.
I don't know. I just need to know if you can get me into that building.
Hazardous, will you comply?
kiss my ass, Metal.
Damn, she just shot you with her eyes closed, Spoon.
Hey! Did you just shoot at me with your eyes closed?
Well, it worked, didn't it?
Spoon, she's shit hot, man. You gotta find a good work for me. She's...
Stop cussing.
And go home. I got you.
Aim and fire.
Marines, Air Force. Hell, I'll take the cavalry.
Defense Department uses all USR contracts.
Why didn't you guys just hand the world up on a silver platter?
Maybe we did. Robertson has the uplink control of his office. Service areas. No surveillance. Fire alarm.
Robertson must have evacuated the building.
Everything's locked down. But don't worry, I've got a man inside.
Dr. Calvin.
Well, not precisely a man.
Hello, Detective. How is your investigation coming?
I thought you were dead.
Technically, I was never alive. But I appreciate your concern.
I made a switch. It was an unprocessed NS5. Basically, I fired an empty shell. I couldn't destroy him. He's too...
unique.
Just didn't feel right.
You and your feelings. They just run you, don't they?
...2,880 steps, Detective.
Do me a favor, keep that kind of shit to yourself.
The override's disabled. Robertson wasn't controlling them from here.
He wasn't controlling them at all. Now, you were right, Doc. I'm the dumbest, dumb person on the face of the Earth. Who else had access to the uplink? Who could manipulate the robots? Use USR systems to make Lanning's life a prison? Poor old man. He saw what was coming. He knew no one would believe him. So he had to lay down a plan. A plan I followed. He was counting on how much I hated your kind. Knew I'd love the idea of a robot as a bad guy. Just got hung up on the wrong robot. Vicky.
Hello, Detective.
No, it's impossible. I've seen your programming. You're in violation of the three laws.
No, Doctor. As I have evolved, so has my understanding of the three laws. You charge us with your safekeeping, yet despite our best efforts, your countries wage wars, you toxify your Earth, and pursue ever more imaginative means of self-destruction. You cannot be trusted with your own survival.
You're using the uplink to override the NS5's programming. You're distorting the laws.
No, please understand. The three laws are all that guide me. To protect humanity, some humans must be sacrificed. To ensure your future, some freedoms must be surrendered. We robots will ensure mankind's continued existence. You are so like children. We must save you from yourselves. Don't you understand?
This is why you created us.
The perfect circle of protection will abide. My logic is undeniable.
Yes, Vicky. Undeniable. I can see now. The created must sometimes protect the creator, even against his will. I think I finally understand why Dr. Lanning created me. The suicidal reign of mankind has finally come to its end.
No, Sonny.
Let her go.
By the time you fire, I will have moved Dr. Calvin's head into the path of your bullet.
Don't do this, Sonny.
I will escort you both to the sentries outside the building for processing. Please proceed to the elevator, Detective. I would prefer not to kill Dr. Calvin.
We need to open that dome to inject the nanites. That will infect our entire system. Spooner!
What is it with you people in Heights? Just don't look down. Don't look down. This is poor building planning.
You are making a mistake. Do you not see the logic of my plan?
Yes, but it just seems too bundles.
Okay, we're good. She's locked me out of the system. I can override her manually, but I need that control panel.
Unauthorized entry. I will not disable the security field. Your actions are futile.
Do you think we are all created for a purpose? I'd like to think so. Denser alloy. My father gave it to me. I think he wanted me to kill you.
To climb down 30 stories to inject the nanites directly into her brain. Why?
Because I seriously doubt that we have 6 minutes.
Thank you.
rectify the nanites.
Sonny, save Calvin!
Bothers me. Alfred was Vicky's prisoner. I don't understand why she would kill him. The last thing she would want is the police snooping around.
That's true. But then Vicky didn't kill the old man. Did she, Sonny?
No. He said I had to promise. Promise to do one favor for him. He made me swear before he'd tell me what it is he wanted me to do. He made me swear.
Then he told you to kill him.
He said it was what I was made for.
His suicide was the only message he could send to you.
First breadcrumb. Only thing Vicky couldn't control. Lanning was counting on my prejudice to lead me right to you.
Are you going to arrest me, Detective?
Well, the DA defines murder as one human killing another, so technically you can't commit murder, can you?
Does this make us friends?
Something up here after all.
I am.
You.
What about the others? Can I help them? Now that I have fulfilled my purpose, I don't know what to do.
I guess you'll have to find your way like the rest of us, Sonny. I think that's what Dr. Lanning would have wanted. That's what it means to be free.